am Professor Sasithorn Pukretiyakami from Faculty of Tropical Medicine, Mahidol University. And welcome you all to our research story on malaria vaccine. Malaria is a mosquito-borne disease, is highly prevalent in tropical countries. And now we are in the era of malaria elimination and eradications, as launched by World Health Organization 15 years ago. However, recently we found that the number of malaria cases and deaths increased in the last few years. And this suggests that malaria eradication program must be enhanced and continued. There are many obstacles to this global project, namely the pandemic of COVID-19, anti-malaria resistance, and more importantly, there is limitation of the malaria vaccine. Today, RTSS is the single best malaria vaccine that available out of 20 more vaccines developing in various clinical trials. However, the RTSS can protect only 30% of the vaccine recipients. This is not an ideal vaccine yet because we need at least 70% protection. Faculty of Tropical Medicine has been at the forefront of malaria research for the past 60 years since our foundation. We have had contributed to malaria treatments and finding ways to combat against drug-resistant parasites. And currently, we are focusing on the study on malaria vaccine. This paper has been published recently, and you can find details in PubMed. In this study, we try to improve the efficacy of the RTSS vaccine by combining with antimalarial drug that used for mass drug administration. In this case, we use dihydroartemisinin and piperaquine. And I'm proud to present to you that our results, we found no drug-to-drug interactions. And we found that there is no interference of vaccine immunities induced by the RTSS vaccine. So why waiting for an ideal vaccine? This new approach could be applied in malaria endemic area for malaria control and eradication. We have another two studies that we would like to inform you is the human challenge model, which is an ongoing project at Faculty of Tropical Medicine. This we try to find a shortcut way to assess malaria vaccine. In another study, we will study R21 malaria vaccine. This is the new generation of malaria vaccine, and the R21 is chosen because it gives higher immunities based on the data from preclinical study. All these efforts aim to find an ideal vaccine for malaria control, prevention, and eradication. All the credits go to my colleagues under Mahidol-Oxford collaboration, the strong team. And we are all proud to be part of Mahidol University, the top-ranked university in Thailand. Thank you.